this is our version of what is often called Y's and T's. Although the shapes we're going to be making are more P's and Q's or X's and O's. I don't know, come up with your own name, trademark it, make a certification for it, make your first million. Our goal here is the same as with any joint. We're trying to strengthen what's weak and open what's tight. In this case, shoulders. This whole complex here tends to be very tight, and a lot of stuff back here tends to be a little weak. We're gonna see if we can rectify that, help it out a little bit. This will lead to improvement in other aspects of our training and movement, so we can do things better. We have an epidemic of tight, rounded shoulders. Again, tight through the front, weak in the back. And this goes for couch potatoes on one end of the spectrum to high-level athletes on the other end of the spectrum. We all seem to be having this problem. And that's because not moving gets us this way, and moving too much in the patterns that we often choose get us this way. So a lot of our training actually creates this pattern. So step one, take a look at your training and see how many things are perpetuating this rounded shoulder, weak upper back, tight front scenario. It doesn't take much to see all these aspects in our training perpetuating this movement cycle. So not only do we have to counter a lot of our training ideas, maybe we need to look at our training and ask ourselves, are those things that are perpetuating this posture actually that beneficial for us in other ways? Usually the answer is no. So the first thing I usually recommend is take a lot of that crap out of your training. But second, also focus on opening here, strengthening back here. I've just attached the bands up over a bar. They can be anywhere from eye level higher, doesn't matter. Attach them to anything you've got that you can pull on. Tubes work great. Thick tubing is actually really hard to use on this. As soon as you start backing up a little bit, getting that little pull, very, very difficult. So be conservative on your tubing usage. It starts by opening up. This sounds easier than it is. I'm going to pull my shoulder blades back, keep my elbows high, but not my shoulders. So the elbows stay high, hands stay high, shoulders stay down, not up here. Now I'm going to suggest that your hands are ear-nose level, because it's actually pretty easy to pull down here. But if we pull ear and nose level, that's a much tougher pull. And that's going to require those rear delts that we're really trying to emphasize here to work a little harder. Ear-nose-ish level, pull, hold. Now here comes the fun part. Lift your shoulders. Back down, close. This comes with some challenges. Generally, if you're not used to this, or you have tight shoulders, or you have a weak upper back, and there's probably a combination of all of that, you'll find that once you start raising your shoulders, everything wants to come forward. So the trick to this is, can you keep your arms back while raising them? Probably won't be able to that well in the beginning. Keep practicing. The other thing to look for is arching the back to make that happen. Keep everything solid through the rib cage. Find your tush, lock your ribs down, keep everything solid. Open, pull up. See right here, everything wants to come forward. So we're gonna keep the elbows back, shoulders forward. So let me just do a few in a row here. I'm screwing my legs into the ground, finding my tush, locking my ribs down. Everything from the ribs down is going to be solid, unmoving. Open, up, down, in. Open, up, down, in. Ear level, nose level, lift the shoulders back. In. If you're a fan of face pulls, which are great, these take it just a little bit further, and there's a postural benefit that crosses over even more so than face pulls. That was part one. Then you turn around for part two, and we're now going to stretch everything here. So in part one, we're trying to turn on the muscles of the upper back. Remember, they tend to be a little weak compared to a lot of the other stuff that's going on, so we need them to catch up. In part two, we're going to open the tight parts, the ones that have been getting stronger, those muscles that tend to be a little more dominant in a lot of movements. They also want to tighten up. This can lead to all sorts of things, particularly bad posture, as well as training difficulty. It's actually tough to get some movement into that joint if it's all tight and bound up. So this is one way to open it up. But now I'm facing away from the band, and I'm gonna start by just relaxing. So the band is high, it doesn't have to be that high, it's just what I'm hanging it on right now. But this actually makes it pull a little bit more. Totally relaxed. From here, I'm just going to pull down. And this is to turn the muscles on, just for a second, because when I turn them off, they're gonna relax even more. And then I raise my shoulders. With that, the arms come up. Then I turn the muscles on again. I'm gonna pull these bands forward a little bit more. And then back, and then relax the shoulders down. This is meant to be slow and controlled. And then up, rise. This one's a little tough, especially if you're using a thick band. You might actually lean into it a little bit, and that's okay. Bear down hard on the belly, find your tush, pull a little bit. Doesn't matter how far you pull, you're just trying to turn the muscles on a little bit. Then those muscles relax as they're turned off. Turn them on a little bit, relax them. Turn them on a little bit. What was the old term for this? People used to call it PNF, proprioceptive neuro blah, 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 blah. Right here, this is the tricky part. Go nice and slow. The temptation is to pull the arms in or to pull the arms forward while doing it. Try to relax and just let the shoulders drop down. Now I'm just pulling the shoulders down. Arms come along for the ride. And here I'm just pulling the shoulders up. Ah, breathing. Arms come along for the ride. How many you do of each one is up to you. 6, 8, 10. Throw them in between sets of other things. If you're doing presses and rows, throw these in between. It works great. Great warm-up, greatest part of a combo. It's up to you how you throw them in, but I highly recommend throwing these.